Hey there. So this series started out being the MESA 5-axis CNC, but then I ended up doing the Monster Machine using two parallel ports because it was already installed and I was too damn lazy to unwire it and redo it. Let's be honest. So I still have the MESA card and set up a lab, and there's a few things I want to teach. So I'm just going to kind of rebrand this as MESA CNC. So, yay! So today's video is pretty short. I'm going to show you electrically how to connect up a stepper motor to the MESA card. And then in the next video, I'm going to go step by step, and I'm going to show you how to do the configuration to get it all to work. But I did have some people that said their steppers are not running, so it's probably an electrical problem. Let's take a look. All right, you notice I stripped out everything here, got all these pins cleared up, and I've got our old friend, the original rotary table, back here. Now, what we're going to do, so push this out of the way, is I have got a stepper driver right here, and if you'll notice, these pins are the inputs which go from the step generators here, and these are two power inputs which will hook up to 24 volts, and then we've got two sets of coils which are the coils for the stepper on here. So what we'll do is we'll connect 24 volts to here and we'll connect up our two coils. Now, having said that, I've got four wires here. I don't know which ones are which. So what I can do is I can grab this and turn it, and I kind of get an idea how much torque there is. Then I say, well, maybe it's the black and the blue wire, and I twist them together and I don't notice any difference. So I go, okay, well, maybe it's the black and the green wire, and I twist them together, and oh yeah, now it's hard to move. So that tells me that the black and green is a pair, and that means that the blue and the red, or the red and the blue, are a pair. So this would go, let's say, to A, and this would go to B. Now, how do I know which one's which? Doesn't really make much difference, because what'll happen is I'll connect the red and blue here, the black and the green here, and then when I tell it to move, if this thing moves, say, clockwise, yay. If it moves counterclockwise, then all I need to do is pick one of these and rotate them to the opposite position and try again, or I can go to the signal that's going to direction and I can invert that, and then it'll run in the opposite direction. So I have a couple of choices there. So rather than have you watch me do it, I'm going to cut a cable for here, connect it up to ground and power. I'm going to connect up the four lines to here, and then we'll take a look at these and what's needed to connect them. Now, I'm going to do an XYZ machine, but what I'm going to do is I'm just going to connect this to the X-axis, because all we really want to do is prove that we can make this turn. And if we can do one axis, we can do 3, 4, 6, 5, whatever. So let's go ahead and get started with that. As you can see, I have the power applied here. I've got the two coils applied here. And then what I did was I took some standard LAN cable, some Cat5 cable, and the pairs for that are typically white, blue, white, orange, white, green, and white, brown. So I stripped out the first two pairs like this, and if you'll notice, there's nothing connected to the enable, because the enable works backward to the way you would think it would work. When there's a signal going through, i.e. when this is active, it's actually telling it not enable. So I leave these two detached. So then what I decided was I decided that the white wires were going to be positive and that this would be the signal. So as you can see, starting at the bottom, we have a pulse 5 volts and a pulse signal. So I've got pair 2 assigned to that. There's the positive and the negative. And then for direction, I have the positive and the negative. And if you look at this, this is the first step generator. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 down here. And the way these pins are outlined is this is 5 volts. This is the direction, positive supply. This is the direction signal. This is the step or pulse, positive supply. This is the pulse signal. And then this is ground. So we've got 5 volts and ground if we needed them. We do not. All we need are these 4 connectors, at least with this model stepper driver. So by connecting these 4 signals and these 4 coils, 4 coil wires, and this power, we've got all the connections we need. Now, there are some switches on this driver. And one thing you have to be aware of is that the first position is NC. That means if it's set to on, it's not going to do anything. So what I did was I just chose 4-step micro-stepping, which is on, off, off. And I made sure that switches 1, 2, and 3 were set that way. And then for the amount of power, I figured I'd start with 2 amps. So I set the switches accordingly. Very important you set these switches accordingly. So having done that, all I've done now is these 4 wires here, going to here, the coils and the power, and I've got a configuration that I already made. Let's give it a try. Now, it's spinning backwards from the way that I want it. I could reverse either this one or this one. I'm not going to. I'm just going to click the invert and I'll be happy with that. So that's the electrical connection. I was going to go into the software in the same video, but I decided not to. I wanted to keep this one short so that you could just watch it and double check your electronics. And then the one that we have for the software side of it, I'm going to set up screen capture and we'll go through it bit by bit, and I'll cover that. That'll be a longer video, and a lot of people will probably just go, yeah, no, and go watch some cats, but that's fine. Hey, I just saw Endgame, you know, and excellent movie, and I really like that the way they